Once again, good morning and welcome. Today we pay special tribute as command of United States Africa Command passes from General David M. Rodriguez to General Thomas D. Waldhauser. Participating in today's review, from left to right, is the United States Army Europe Band, under the direction of Major Dwayne Milburn. Elements of United States Africa Command include United States Army Africa, led by Colonel Clint Kirk. Next online is United States Marine Forces Africa, led by Colonel John S. Hetland. Since the days of the American Revolution, the colors have been one of the most important elements in a military unit, as members kept their position in formation by dressing on the colors. At the center of today's formation, and bearing the national color, is Africa Command's Joint Color Guard, led by Senior Master Sergeant Xavier Sanford. Next online is United States Naval Forces Africa, led by Captain Greg Romero. Next online is United States Air Forces Africa, led by Colonel Craig Rice. The last element online is Special Operations Command Africa, led by Colonel Joe Duncan. Ladies and gentlemen, moving into position is the commander of troops for today's ceremony, Major General Roger L. Cloutier, Chief of Staff, United States Africa Command. Ladies and gentlemen, taking the reviewing stand is the reviewing official for today's ceremony, General David M. Rodriguez, United States Africa Command outgoing commander, accompanied by General Thomas D. Waldhauser, the incoming commander, and our host for today's ceremony, General Joseph F. Dunford, Jr., 19th Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand as honors are rendered and remain standing for the invocation offered by Chaplain Stephen Pike, United States Africa Command Chaplain.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, today as we gather to witness this time-honored ceremony of the change of command, we pause to give you thanks. We are thankful for the beautiful day as we remember in humble recognition of the privilege that is ours to wear the cloth of our nation in service in its armed forces. Today we give you thanks for General Rodriguez and his leadership of Africom over the past 3.5 years. We are thankful for his vision and for his leadership, for the wisdom he has brought to our command, and for his deep concern for this the people of Africa. We are thankful, too, for Jenny and the tremendous contribution she has made to our Stuttgart military community, for her graciousness, her compassion, and the camaraderie that she has shared with all of us. We welcome General Waldhauser and Gail to Africom. May your blessings continue to be upon him as he assumes command. Bless him and inspire him with discernment, with health and stamina as he leads us forward. And we pray for Gail and for the Waldhauser family that you will bless and keep them always. And finally, Lord, we pray for our country, for the men and women in local, state, and national government, and for those who serve and protect the peace in our communities. Be with our great nation always. For it is in your holy and almighty name we pray. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the advancing of the colors and remain standing for the playing of the Federal Republic of Germany and the United States of America national anthems. Please be seated. spouses play a very important role, not only in the success and balance of our service members, but also with their families. At this time, Mrs. Rodriguez is being presented a bouquet of red roses in appreciation for her dedication and support to the men and women of United States Africa Command and their families. Also, Mrs. Waldhauser is being presented with a bouquet of yellow roses, which signifies the trust and friendship that will develop as a member of the Stuttgart community and United States Africa Command. Ladies and gentlemen, General Dunford.
Hey, good morning. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and most importantly to the men and women of the United States Africa Command. It's an honor to be here as we mark the transfer of authority between General Dave Rodriguez and General Tom Waldhauser. And I'd like to begin by recognizing Command Sergeant Major Troxell, Command Sergeant Major Bond, and the other senior enlisted leaders that are gathered here this morning. Thanks for who you are and what you do, and more importantly, thanks for representing the true backbone of the Joint Force, our non-commissioned officers. And Sergeant Major Bond today, Command Sergeant Major Bond, today is your last day at the United States AFRICOM as well, and I'd like to thank you for your leadership. I'd also like to acknowledge the many leaders here representing the U.S. government interagency, our allies, and our regional partners. Thanks for your presence, thanks for your support, and thank you for your long-standing cooperation. We're all stronger because of our friendship and our shared commitment. Today's ceremony formally recognizes the transfer of command, but AFRICOM's vital role remains unchanged. And so I like to say that changes of command are actually more about continuity than they are about change. Tomorrow morning, just like this morning, the men and women of AFRICOM will wake up with complete commitment to the mission and trust in their leadership. Change of command ceremonies also offer a great opportunity to reflect and take stock of an organization's accomplishment, and so I'd like to take just a few minutes to talk about the command. To say that the United States AFRICOM Command's mission is dynamic and challenging would be an understatement. But as General Rodriguez has said, where there's great challenge, there's also great opportunity. African economies, populations, and influence continue to grow, while the continent's military forces, security institutions, and governments seek to enhance their capabilities and their effectiveness. And that dynamic is why I share the perspective that investment in the development and security of Africa offers disproportionate benefit to Africa, to Europe, to the United States. And that's what makes the mission of the United States Africa Command so important. That said, I don't have to tell the men and women in this audience that AFRICOM has a tough job. In partnership with 53 African nations, the command tackles challenges that range from Ebola to countering violent extremism, and from defense institution building to countering illicit trafficking and piracy. The responsibilities of AFRICOM highlight both the complexity of today's security environment and the demand for a capable, flexible, and responsive joint force. And for the last 3 years, AFRICOM has been just that, an exceptional joint team and the core element of a highly effective combined interagency team. To the men and women of the United States Africa Command, I want you to know that your contributions are both recognized and greatly appreciated. We've asked an awful lot of you, and you've delivered every time. In fact, aside from this morning's ceremony, today is really a typical day in AFRICOM. As we gather here, Joint Special Operations Forces are working closely with African Union partners to combat Al-Shabaab in Somalia. Members of the team are training Cameroonian partners on counter IEDs and enabling Nigerians to improve their logistics and border security. In Niger, AFRICOM is training specialized units for countering violent extremism. In Libya, AFRICOM has conducted strikes against threats to the homeland and our regional partners. And all of these efforts contribute to both regional security and the fight against transnational terrorism. In the Gulf of Guinea, sailors are building partner capacity to counter illicit trafficking in piracy. In South Sudan, Africom is responding to the most recent crisis, protecting the U.S. diplomatic presence and providing a source of stability. Across the continent, National Guard-State partnerships are deepening our relationships and enhancing our interoperability. Ladies and gentlemen, I could go on at much greater length about this superb team's contributions. Suffice to say that the men and women of the United States Africa Command are making a difference. And for the last 3 years, AFRICOM's performance has reflected the visionary leadership of General Dave Rodriguez. I've known and admired Rod for over a decade and had the opportunity to watch him lead in Iraq, in Afghanistan, and in the Pentagon. As a warrior and as a strategic thinker, General Rodriguez is without peer. And his service as a combatant commander is the culmination of a career spanning over 40 years. Rod has led at every level, and his career has followed the arc of history. He was a rifle platoon leader in the Army rebuilding after Vietnam. He was a company commander in Germany prepared to defend Europe during the Cold War. He was a plank owner in the 75th Ranger Regiment as the Army grew its special operations capability. He shaped the evolution of Army doctrine in the 1990s. And since 9/11, Rod's been on point, taking the fight to violent extremism. Through it all, he's earned a reputation for being a soldier's soldier, a candid, competent, no-nonsense leader with rock-solid character. Most importantly, Rod never takes credit for himself. When asked what he's most proud of as the AFRICOM commander, he's quick to highlight the work of this team's African, European, and interagency partners. He consistently looks for opportunities to recognize the performance of others, a character trait that's been reflected in his entire 40 years of service. And of course, Rod hasn't walked this journey alone. He's had great support on the home front. To Rod's wife, Jenny, thanks for sharing your husband with the Army and with our nation. You've served side by side with Rod for the past 34 years, and you work as a fierce advocate for military families and a valued mentor and role model for countless military spouses is greatly appreciated. You made 22 moves. You've had 5 deployments, and that's the long ones, not counting all the short ones, and you've raised 4 children, often by yourself. And I'll just tell you this morning, Ellen and I joined the many military families that you've touched along the way in saying thank you. And you get a lot of fans out there, the Dunfords included. And also to Amy, Melissa, David, and Andrew, who aren't here today, thanks for sharing your dad. In a few weeks, we're going to honor the Rodriguez's 4 decades of service at a formal retirement ceremony. But for now, Rod and Jenny, please know that as you prepare to depart AFRICOM and our active ranks, you do so with the admiration, the appreciation, and the affection of thousands that you've touched along the way, the Dunfords included. Fortunately for AFRICOM and the nation, we didn't have to look far to find another superb leader to take the helm at the United States Africa Command. And I can assure the men and women of AFRICOM that in General Tom Waldhauser, you're getting the best our nation has to offer. I've known Tom since we were lieutenants together in the same battalion. And since those early days, Tom's leadership, his character, and his vision were clear. He quickly garnered a reputation for balancing an exacting demand for excellence with a genuine care for his Marines and his troops. He led from the front at every level of the Marine Corps and served the joint force with distinction. He's known as one of the most operationally competent leaders we have in our force today. He led the 15th Marine Expeditionary Unit in the early days after 9/11, planning, executing, and conducting operations in Pakistan, Djibouti, Afghanistan, and Iraq. He commanded a division, a Marine Expeditionary Force, and Marine Forces Central Command. He demonstrated strategic vision as the commanding general of the Marine Corps Warfighting Laboratory, where he helped shape the next generation of Marine Corps doctrine and concepts. And for the last 3 years, Tom drove the development of the capabilities and leaders the joint force will need in the future. For almost 40 years, I've admired Tom as a fellow Marine, a warrior, and a leader, and most of all, as a friend. And to Tom's wife, Gail, thanks for your sacrifice and support and your friendship, Gail. And in particular, thanks for agreeing to share Tom for just a few more years. And I know you've been here for less than 48 hours on a number of countless moves. And I also appreciate the sacrifice of Amy, Kate, and Mark, who aren't here, but I know they're here in spirit. So, Gail, welcome to AFRICOM. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being here as we recognize AFRICOM's accomplishments under General Dave Rodriguez, and we welcome General Waldhauser aboard. At this time, it's my honor to introduce a warrior, a leader, a soldier's soldier, and a man that I am proud to call a friend, General Dave Rodriguez.
Oh, my goodness. Chairman and Mrs. Dunford, thank you for being here today. And also thanks to our German host, represented by Dr. Scherer, the Mayor of Stuttgart, and Baron von Rassler, who always comes out to support the Americans everywhere. Welcome to the Chairman of the European Union Military Committee, General Kostarakis. Good to see you. And a special welcome to representatives from our African partner nations, especially. And I'll say this the way I always say to General Odierno, General O, the Nigerian Chief of Defense, Lieutenant Cassion, the Vice Chief of Kenyan Defense, and Major General Goswani, the Chief of Defense of Mauritania. We're also joined by many of our partners here, Lieutenant General Lorimer and Major General Delort Laval from France and the UK, respectively. And thanks to everybody who put this ceremony on today, protocol, the band, the personal security detachment, the communications, the front office, troops to your front. Hey, let's give them a round of applause, please. And Colonel Gillen and Sergeant Major Stitzel, and of course, Mike Franken and Ambassador Lascaris, who helped lead this organization. And then a special thanks to our UCOM partners, represented here by both SCAP and Garrett. So these two guys have been longtime friends of mine, and I forgot to tell you, Tom, SCAP has followed me several times, so he knows how to clean up after me, so you might want to get some advice from him. But thank you very much for being here, and of course, Garrison, for what they do every single day. Now, when I arrived at AFRICOM to assume command from General Hamm just a little over 3 years ago, I thought I was well prepared. I've been a soldier for almost 40 years, and commanded all levels and in all sorts of challenging environments, I thought. I felt ready to tackle a new assignment, confident in my knowledge and leadership, but as they say, only fools rush in. Now, I've learned a lot about Africa and many other things since then, and despite my steep learning curve, I'm extremely proud of everything we've accomplished here at Africa Command and in Africa with our partners, our allies, and the interagency team. Now, before I came to AFRICOM, I moved an entire airborne division, but I would have never guessed how difficult it would be to evacuate an embassy. There are so many moving pieces on such a tight timeline and with so much at stake. And we have to constantly monitor the security situation, pull together available equipment and transportation, sort out diplomatic clearances for relocation sites, and ensure proper medical support. Of course, communications and logistics all have to be in place, and we've even evacuated pets. And we did it all together. And again, I learned something new. I've learned that this sort of event was possible only because great people came together to coordinate across agency lines and across borders. AFRICOM's success in responding to crisis exemplifies the close and interdependent relationships we have with our State Department and interagency colleagues. And because of the generosity of our African partners, AFRICOM has been able to improve our responsiveness, our posture, our access, and many agreements to increase the security for U.S. personnel and facilities on the continent. Now, before I came to AFRICOM, everything I knew about maritime security, I'm sorry, Michelle, I learned from watching Captain Phillips. But it turns out maritime security is a little more than having ships capable of interdicting pirates. It includes principles like freedom of navigation, mariner safety, marine environmental protection, and the sustainable use of ocean resources. And it's complicated as we seek to help our partners find appropriate solutions to a multitude of threats and problems that go beyond piracy to include issues like illicit trafficking and migration. And we've seen you use progress. And again, I learned a little bit more about life. I've learned that regional cooperation is the cornerstone to building a more secure maritime domain, and AFRICOM's support to these regional cooperation's efforts through expanded security force assistance, training, and joint operations is the right approach in my mind. Coordination has strengthened regional institutions by helping to develop integrated national maritime strategies and help build our partners' capacity to support information sharing and multinational maritime coordination centers. and exercises like Obengami Express, which brought together 16 African nations, as well as international partners from both Europe and South America, further enhance cooperation and build capacity in key areas like search and rescue operations. Together, we fundamentally have changed the nature of the maritime environment off the Horn of Africa. Now, before I came to Africom, I couldn't tell the difference between hand lotion and hand sanitizer. And I would never have believed that together we could help halt the spread of a deadly and contagious virus like Ebola so quickly. Disease crises like this one can destabilize governments and entire regions, erode public trust and confidence, and lead to panic and threaten security. And the statistics of the fatalities and new cases were terribly alarming, and the virus showed us all how quickly and easily it could jump borders. And together, we contained the outbreak. I learned that global threats can actually be solved by a global response with each nation, agency, and organization playing to its strengths in a coordinated effort. With USAID in the lead of U.S. efforts, AFRICOM rapidly responded to requests and provided personnel and equipment to facilitate communications and coordination, logistics, engineering support, and training for healthcare workers. We saw success in building partner capacity as we worked closely with our Liberian partners to build hospitals, treatment units, and diagnostic facilities. I saw how security force assistance and the state partnership program strengthened the defense institutions. And the investment in the Liberian Armed Forces demonstrated its value during the Ebola crisis as they were an effective security force and maintained order and rule of law throughout the epidemic. And to be perfectly clear, Ebola was defeated first and foremost by our African populations and their leaders. And we are proud of the role we had in assisting them, but nothing should diminish the international reputation our partners earned through their energy, commitment, and wisdom. Now, these lessons just scratch the surface of everything I've learned here at AFRICOM. And of course, every position that I've held in the U.S. military taught me something. But my position as the commander of AFRICOM is the one in which I'm most proud. The command embodies the spirit of the African proverb that AFRICOM has been quoting long before my time here, and I hope a long time after. If you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. That's why we've accomplished things, because we've done it together with our partners in Africa, in Europe, and within the U.S. government. And it is to those partnerships which will enable each of you to continue to succeed in the future. Speaking of partnerships, as the chairman said, I'd like to say a special thanks to Sergeant Major Bond, who's been my partner since 2009. He's participating in his next to last ceremony today and will retire after this assignment. And Sergeant Major, thank you for everything. The work that all of you do on behalf of our nation is important. I hope that you continue to work together to identify where wise investments in African security institutions will make the biggest difference. African solutions to African problems are, in the long run, in the best interest of Africans and indeed the world. Now, before I hand the reins over to General Waldhauser, a trusted colleague and superb leader, I'd like to take a moment and recognize all of your families. Just as I am ever grateful to Ginny and my family for their steadfast love and support, I thank your families too. And every team needs a leader, and my family has been led by our leader, Ginny, for many, many years. And also, of course, she leads the families here in AFRICOM, as she's done at every place we've been. So, dear, thank you very much. Now, families out there make the greatest sacrifice for our common cause and should take the greatest pride in what we have accomplished. So I'd like to make a special welcome also to General Waldhauser's wife, Gail, his mother, Joan, sister, Barb, and her husband, John, and his brother, Jim, and his wife, Shelley. Thank you all for being here to help celebrate this special occasion with Tom and Gail. It's been an honor to serve as your commander, and Ginny and I are grateful for our time here in Stuttgart and at AFRICOM. I'm proud of this organization, not just for what it has achieved, but for the direction in which it is headed. I wish you all the best as AFRICOM continues to work with the interagency, our allies, and our partners to support African efforts to strengthen democratic institutions, spur economic growth, advance peace and security, and promote opportunity and development throughout Africa. Forward together. Thank you.
The change of command is a time-honored tradition that runs deep in symbolism and heritage. In times past, the colors were an actual rallying point for troops in battle. In many ways, unit colors provide the same purpose today, to draw service members together for a common action. A unit relies upon the unity and loyalty of its members for success in either battle or garrison. The colors are the visible symbol of that unity and loyalty. The command senior enlisted leader is the custodian of the colors. When the colors are not displayed for the commander, they are in the care of the command senior enlisted leader. And today, Command Sergeant Major Darren Bond, who departs the command as well, presents the colors to the commander for the last time. Headquarters, United States Africa Command, 18 July 2016. Subject, assumption of command by assignment of the President. The undersigned assumes command of United States Africa Command, effective 18 July 2016. Signed, Thomas D. Waldhauser, General, United States Marine Corps, commanding. Ladies and gentlemen, General Waldhauser.
Good morning, everyone. I wanted to start this morning by saying that I'm a firm believer in the new guy should be very brief at ceremonies such as this. And after being on the ground for only 48 hours, as the chairman indicated a bit earlier, I think it's only appropriate today that I be brief. But I want to begin this morning by saying a few very sincere thank yous. And the first is the Secretary of Defense and the President for the nomination for this challenging assignment. I'm very grateful for that. I also want to thank my wife, Gail, who's been mentioned here this morning several times, for all of her support and many contributions over the years. We could not have done that without you, dear. Thank you very much. And Rod was very kind to mention our children who are not here today, Amy, Kate, and Mark, and their husbands. And I know they wish they would be here, but we're very grateful for what they've done over the years as well. My immediate family flew from Minnesota to be here today. My mother, who's 86, and John, Barb, and Jim and Shelley, who were mentioned, thank you very much. I didn't want to say your age, but I did, and it slipped. So I'm sure I'll hear about that afterwards. More than once, I'm most sure. And obviously, I want to thank General Dunford and his wife, Ellen, for being here today and officiating this ceremony. General Dunford and I go way back. We're true friends. And thank you, Chairman, for doing this today. It's very, very meaningful. I also want to thank the German hosts who are here today and all who are our neighbors. It's great pride and great privilege to call you our neighbors. And we look forward to working with you very, very much. I also want to thank all of those who helped set up the parade, assist in the parade today, and all those who participated. Thank you very much. I know that's not why you joined. So again, we truly appreciate your efforts here this morning. And I want to thank all those who traveled here today from our African nations and our European partners. Thank you for being here today. You honor us as part of this ceremony. And finally, I want to say a special thank you to Rod and Ginny. You both have done a tremendous job here. You've been very gracious and considerate hosts during this transition. And Gail and I now call you friends. So thank you very much. And we wish you all the best as you return to the United States after many years of service to both the Army and to this great nation. To the men and women of Africom, I certainly recognize the many complicated and diverse challenges this command faces every day across the vast African continent. It is up to us to bring forward creative and viable solutions to these challenges and view each one as an opportunity to work with and assist our African partners not only today, but in the future as well, in building a secure, a stable, and prosperous African continent. I look forward to meeting and working with each of you in the days ahead. And once again, I'm honored to be here. So I want to thank you again, and I look forward to getting to work. Semper Fidelis.
Africa!
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the playing of the service medleys. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes today's ceremony. Please remain in place for the departure of the official party and our distinguished guests. Please say farewell to General and Mrs. Rodriguez as you exit today. Once again, thank you for your attendance and enjoy the rest of your day.